Hello everyone, this is Neil Davis from Digital Cloud Training. So every now and then AWS revises their exams and brings out a new version of a specific AWS certification exam. Now this time it's the Developer Associate. It's been a long time coming. The DVA-C01, the current version of the exam, has been around a long time now, and I was expecting them to make this announcement, and they have done. And so it's actually coming quite soon. There will be a new version of the exam. And in this video, I just want to talk to you about what to expect and how you can prepare yourself for the new version of the exam. So we're moving from the C01 to C02. Now, I always hear a lot of fear, uncertainty and doubt from my students when an exam changes. People worry that their certification is going to expire, that the certification program itself is retiring or changing in some major way, and maybe the topics are going to be extremely different, so they need a completely new course. They also worry that the exam is going to be much harder and that there's going to be hands-on testing, or that they need a completely new course in order to study. So the truth is that none of those things are true. Now, AWS certifications last for 3 years from when you earn them, and they are not exam code specific. It will not mention on your certification which exam you actually passed. So your certification is not going to expire until the end of that 3 year period. Now, it's just a revision to the exam. People worry that when there's a new exam code, the exam's going to be completely different, but it isn't. It's just that they've introduced some new services and topics. The vast majority of the exam, the core, if you like, of the exam content is going to be the same. So most of the exam is the same. Difficulty should be about the same, but there's going to be some more topics. So there will be a little additional study you need to do, but mostly it's going to be the same. Now, the only exam from AWS that has a hands-on component is the SysOps Administrator Associate, and it's not coming for the DVA-C02. So really, you just need to study some extra topics and you're going to be well set for this exam. So let's have a look in a bit more detail. The DVA-C02 is an associate level exam. It's 130 minutes long and 65 questions. It costs $150. Now, if you do have a voucher from passing a previous exam, you can use that to get a 50% discount. You can take it in a testing center or online. The exam is scored on a scaling scoring system between 100 and 1,000 points, and you need 720 to pass the exam. So let's look at the comparison between the topics covered in C01 and C02. These are the exam domains. On the left, we've got the C01, and on the right, we've got the new exam. And as you can see, they're a little bit different. So they also map slightly differently. So domain 1 deployment is now domain 3. Domain 2 security has stayed as domain 2. Domain 3 development with AWS services is identical, but now it's domain 1 in the new exam. Then refactoring, there's not really an equivalent there, but domain 5 monitoring and troubleshooting is closest to domain 4 troubleshooting and optimization. So what does that mean? It means that the content in the exam is much the same as it was before. They've optimized it slightly and the weightings are also slightly different. Now, what is the difference in scope in terms of services? Well, the DVA-C01, so the old exam, had around 33 services included. The new exam has about 57 services, so that's quite a lot more. Now, I wouldn't worry too much about that. We had this recently with the Solutions Architect Associate exam when it went to a new version. A lot more services were added in, so of course we updated our courses and everyone learned those topics. But when they got to the exam, most people found there weren't many questions covering those new topics. There'll just be a few. The core of the exam is unchanged. It's the same services. So with the DVA, it's all about the Lambda and Elastic Beanstalk and the developer tools. Those kind of tools and services are really the core body of the exam. This is the exam guide for the Certified Developer Associate DVA-C02. Now, if I scroll down a little way, you're going to find that the response types are the same. So you've got multiple choice and multiple response. Now, the exam does have 15 unscored questions that do not affect your score. So out of those 65 questions, 50 of them are scored and 15 are used by AWS for research. Now, if we scroll down a little bit further, we've seen the domains and there's a lot more information on the exact topics within those domains, but I want to scroll down and have a look at the services that are included in the scope of this exam. In the appendix here, we can see which key tools, technologies, and concepts might be covered on the exam. And of course, we'd expect there to be coverage of developer tools and compute and analytics and application integration and more. We can see in analytics, we've got Athena and Kinesis and OpenSearch. There's a few of the newer services like AppSync have been added in. We can see new services under containers like Copilot and Elastic Kubernetes services now covered in this exam as well. For databases, much the same as it was before, except for the addition of MemoryDB for Redis. And then, of course, we've got the developer tools. They're a big component of the Developer Associate exam. So as you can see, there are quite a lot of services in here. Now, what we're going to do, of course, is make sure that we add lessons and practice questions to our courses to cover all of these. I would say again that most of the core body of the exam, most of the questions is going to be the services that were in the old version of the exam, but you do need to have some knowledge of the newer ones as well. Let's look at the key dates you need to understand. The last day to take the current exam is February 27th, 2023. And then the first day to take the updated exam is February the 8th, 2023. So make sure if you're taking the exam after February 27th, you need to make sure that you are learning those new topics and you're going to be taking the new version of the exam from those dates. Now, I'll just cover a few frequently asked questions. So, do I need to recertify? Only if your current certification is expiring. So remember that you have 3 years. So if you've already got the certification, the version is not mentioned on the certification. So as long as it's valid and current, then you're all good. If you're close to expiration date, then you might want to look at recertifying. Is there an exam lab component? I mentioned this before. No, there isn't. The only exam from AWS with an exam lab is the SysOps Administrator Associate. When will the Digital Cloud Training course be updated? So we'll be adding new videos and new practice questions to our courses before the exam is released. And then, of course, as we learn more information about the topics that are coming up, we'll add more post-release as well. Do I need to purchase the course again? No, you do not. So if you already have an active subscription to our courses, you will get the new topics for free. And lastly, I'm already studying for the DVA-C01. Should I continue or switch to the DVA-C02? Of course, this really depends on when you're watching this video and how close we are to that cutoff date, and also where you are in your study. If you're almost ready to take the exam and there's enough time to do it before the last day of the current exam, then by all means, carry on. Otherwise, start thinking about making sure that you're learning those new topics for the DVA-C02.